Today I will explain how I made my 3D printing letters with logos in Fusion 360. Stay tuned! Hello friend, welcome back! It's always a pleasure having you here watching this video. A lot of people have been asking how I make my 3D letterings and logos like this one.
I will explain how you can choose the font type, size and how to put a logo or symbol in the lettering. For start, I open a new document in Adobe Illustrator and choose the size of the lettering I want to do. And I press OK. A new document is created and we are ready to start. Now we write what we intend. In this case, I will write the name of this channel. Now we choose the font we want and the size. And we have our text. Take our logo and drag and drop here. Then we click on Image Trace and then Expand. Now we remove the white background from the logo. Let's put everything in place as we wish. We can resize our logo. Let's align everything. We select the text and with the right mouse button we choose Create Outlines. Create Outlines is important because otherwise on save the text may not keep the font we want. Let's now save our document in 2D. Choose Save with SVG extension. I have here a document already created with the same name that I will rewrite. And then click OK. Now we have a 2D document ready. Let's open our Fusion 360 and press the S key and type center and choose the center rectangle. Choose the orientation, click on the center and choose the size of the rectangle. I will put 50 and 200 and we have our base. Now click on insert. Then insert SVG, click on this folder and choose your SVG and your text will appear down here. Now you can drag and drop your text to inside the base. Then click OK. Now let's draw a line that will serve as an axis for our text to gain the 3D aspect. Press the L key and drag your line. Remember, this will be your axis. Click Finish Sketch. Select all the text. Go to Create and Revolve. In the profile, we choose all the text we want in 3D. On the axis, we choose the line we draw. And the revolve will appear. We have the text in 360 degrees, but this is not what we want. We put here in this box only 45 degrees. And we have our text. We already have our text, but our base is missing, that we already drew. Let's editing our first sketch, and we have here our base. Let's turn around our text, select the base, and press the E key to extrude the base. And don't forget, select all the parts that you want to extrude. I will leave some holes for a nice effect. I will extrude 5 mm. Check the result. Make sure that you have a new body option selected and press OK. Now press the F key and select the four corners of the base. And push it to inside. Now we have the corners routed. And press OK and let's prepare to make the print with two colors. Let's save as STL our base. Press OK. Give a name to a file. We will write a base. Now create a new component and select all parts of the text and drag and drop to the new component and save as STL. Give a name and that's it. Our work on Fusion 360 is finishing. Now open your Simplify 3D and drag and drop your files. Select all files, click Edit, and select Align Selected Models Origins, and your letters will be aligned with the base. Now click Edit Process Settings, and select Models, and select the model, press OK, and prepare to print, and your base will appear. Save the file, give the name that you wish, in this case base, press exit and click edit process settings. For the people who have AutoBed leveling, which is my case, I will have to remove G29 from initial script, and on G28 I will just do home on X and Y axis. Now we select the other file and press OK. And prepare to print again. And save the file. I'm saving two different processes because I will print my lettering with two colors. White on the base and blue on the text. I will load now the filament on my CR10 to print the base. The CR10 are ready to print. Let's make the AutoBed leveling. In this case I'm using the AutoLev, the sensor for AutoBed leveling. The sensor is taking measurements of the distance between the nozzle and the bed, so that during printing correct all bed levels or even bed warps. The link for the sensor is in the video description. Let's start printing our white base. And the print of our base is complete. Now let's change the filament and load the blue one. The printer will do home on the X and Y axis, imprint the intro line and start imprinting the blue letters up on our white base. Now we just wait for the printer to finish its work. Our lettering is complete. Let's get it out of the bed and see how it looks. And that's it. We have our 3D text.
I hope I've explained well the process I used to make these letterings. And guys, I hope you enjoyed. If so, don't forget leave that thumbs up so the YouTube would share this video with other users. If you are new here, consider subscribing the channel and activate the bell for when I upload the new content, you'll get the notification. Thanks for watching this video and see you at the next time. Until there, a big hug to all of you. Bye.